What's up, guys? Welcome back to IFIXSMARTSOLUTIONS. Today, we have a Macbook Pro Max M3 14-inch 2023 that has a faulty screen. Actually, it's a damaged screen. Right here, we have a new screen with us. Let's change it. Using a P5 or Pentel 5 screwdriver, remove the 8 screws from the bottom case. Let's use a suction cup to deattach the bottom case. Insert the black stick tool on the gap antenna to finish opening the base cover and remove it. Always use your ESD protection. First things first, disconnect the battery flex cable. Using a T3 bit, remove the 2 screws from the cowling. Then remove the cowling. Disconnect trackpad flex cable. Using a T5 bit, remove screws from the BMU unit and disconnect it. Now we can safely move to the screen. Before removing the screen, we need to remove the antenna, clutch covers, and some cowlings. Using a T3 bit, let's remove 6 screws from the cowlings. Then remove the cowlings. Remove 3 screws from the antenna, then remove the cowling. Now disconnect all the screen flex cables, lead angle sensor, and the antenna. Using a T5, we've removed the 4 screws from the clutch covers.
Now we're going to remove the antenna, which is this whole unit right here. Using a T5 again, you're going to remove the screws that holds the antenna. Now we need to remove the 9 screws or little screws from the antenna. For that, you need to use a P1. Now, to remove the antenna, you can just pull it and just remove also the clutch covers. Now, flipping over the laptop, we're gonna remove the screws that hold the hinges, but before that, we're gonna remove the lead angle sensor. Here's the lead angle sensor. So the reason we are changing this is every time you change the screen, you must also replace the lead angle sensor. So if you don't do, yes, the screen will work, but there are some functions that will not work. Like when you open a MacBook laptop, it will turn on right away. So this is the lead angle sensor basically does that. And no, you can just put anyone. It has to be one that is linked by Apple with that screen that you are replacing. So remember, if you change on your screen and you don't change the lead angle sensor, that function of wake up when you open the computer won't work on your laptop. But the screen will just work normally. So we're now using a T9 to remove the screws that hold the hinges. Once all the screws are out, only thing you gotta do is just wiggle the screen and remove it. Okay, we got the new screen, let's just install it. When you install the new screen, make sure that the connectors are not trapped between the screen and the keyboard. Make sure they're always inside on this side of the screen. because you don't want to damage it and damage the screen also. Go ahead and reinstall the 6 screw, but do not tighten all the way. Before you do that, make sure the screen is flush and is well aligned on the size. Once you confirm that, go ahead and tighten all the screws. Now let's go align the cables. Okay, I had to do it because it was really hard to do with only one hand, but pretty much you want to put the cable in the same position that it was. The rest of the cable, they will always go on the inside, and then you can just install the clutch covers. This one will go this way, this other one will go this way. Then we can go ahead and install the antenna. Remember that you gotta install the clutch covers before installing the antenna. If you do the antenna, then you won't be able to install these guys. And then we're just going ahead and install all the screws. Remember the one for the clutch covers and the one for the antennas. And here we have the new lid angle sensor. Let's install it right now. We don't want to forget the 96 small screws that go on the antenna. Now let's install all the connectors. Alright, they are all installed. I need to do it with both of my hands. So they are very tricky. You gotta be patient, also be careful, don't force them too much. Just make sure they are first aligned, and then you push down a little bit, you should be able to hear a click. And also the antenna, they are a bit tricky, so just put it in place and use your tool, press it down, and they should go to place. Now let's install the cowlings and the screws. Don't forget the antenna cowlings and the screw. Now let's reinstall the BMU screw. Let's reconnect trackpad, trackpad cowlings and screws, and let's go ahead and connect the battery. Let's reinstall the cover. As you see, there are some hooks on the back side of the cover. Those need to hook on the back side of the laptop. Just turn it around to make it easier. It was installed. Gotta do the screws. Oh, the screws are already in. Nice, much better. Right, so this is how you change your screen on your MacBook 2023 Pro Max. See you in the next one.